Hello, everybody. We are back here on Cabela's Big Game Hunter Pro Hunts once again. This time, doing our first hunt on the Northeast region. This is going to be so much fun. I am super excited to finally get a chance to hunt some of these animals like the caribou and the moose. That's going to be super, super fun. I believe it's caribou, at least, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it's a caribou. Yes, it is a caribou. Okay, so that's going to be a lot of fun. Now, I think to start out, we're going to do some of the, like, challenge hunts right here. So, moose with a shotgun, no thanks. Moose with a bow, we could do that, but no. Let's do this one. Hunt one caribou from a stand or a blind. This is going to be sick. I am super excited for this. Let's start at, like, 9. And let's start with our 338 and see how things go. Hopefully, things will go quite well. This is our first attempt at this region. So I'm really hoping that it's going to go well. Because I know nothing about the area. Oh, crap. Right up there? Is there something right there already? Oh, yeah. Okay. So we got to go that way. We're going to try to get into the sand, which, ooh, that's like... wind's not great, so we need to go there. We need to get to that stand, if I'm not mistaken. Might be a bad move, but I feel like it's our only move, really, because that other one, the wind is going to be blowing towards them, which would be worse. Thing is, I don't know what the visibility is going to be like. I don't know how much of an opening we'll have to take shots. It looks like right now we're good to kind of just walk. They don't seem to notice that we're here. Oh, crap. Hi. That scared the crap out of me. So, what else do we have to do here? 10 coyotes from more than 75 yards? I mean, we can do that easy, so we'll just have to keep an eye out for where the coyotes are and try to complete that challenge, because that's going to be some good money. Crap, they're right there. Not the coyotes, but the caribou. They're right there. So we got to be really, really careful and just ease our way over to the stand. Come on, we're almost there. We're so close to the stand, we should be able to see them very, very shortly. Think I can just get up? There we go. Oh no. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to see them. No. We can't even see them from here. That sucks. So, out of that point of interest, what's a better location to attempt this? Probably this one. That looks way better. Yeah, so we'll make that our new target, but we're going to kill one of these caribou that's right here first. Mainly because I really want to see them up close. I want to see what type of size we're looking at here. Because just from like the loading screen, it looks like they get pretty huge. And I'm really curious to see what they look like. Oh, it's a bear! It's a bear. No wonder I couldn't see any caribou. Because it's a bear. Well, I'll take that, I guess.
Double lung shot. Excellent shot placement. Won't go far.
And while I'm thinking of it, let's turn down the announcer volume again. I need to only have that on for the pro hunts, because otherwise it just gets annoying. It constantly like interrupts me. There, I think that's going to be a lot better. Let's go chase down this little bear, and then we'll kind of move around the area and try to get into position for this challenge with the caribou. Looks like this thing has not died yet, as far as I can tell. But there's no way it runs very far. I mean, we're using a 338, so it should be fine. How perfect. It started running off in the direction I need to go, and it just died. Perfect. There's our bear right there. I actually passed him up at first. 1,200 credits. We'll take that. And then there's a moose over here. I don't know if I spooked him off or not. Yeah, he's right there. I think we'll try to kill him, but we only have 2 hours left before the hunt kind of ends. I just noticed that, so that's unfortunate. Hey, little guy. Let's go ahead and take a shot on this beast. This should be good. The 338 has crazy penetration. Yeah, it's got to hit. Ribs, though. Ooh. Not the greatest. I mean, it died, though. In fact, it died really quick. I think we're going to lose points, though, so that sucks. We may end up just restarting the hunt so we don't get the negative credits, and also because the caribou aren't even here right now. So I think I might need to change the time to a better time for the caribou to actually be in their zones. I feel like we were in a transitional period. Yes, we were. Okay, so they're in resting zones now, and it's currently 10. So I probably need to set the time clear back to like 8, maybe 7. I'd say 8's probably going to be where we need to set it to. Yeah, negative 75. Yikes. So I think we will restart the level. Actually, no, we're going to quit. No, I think the only way we can do this and not lose credits... Well, I mean, we won't lose credits because we did get the bear. So let's just quit. Yeah, there we go. 11:25. So we need to redo that because we could not find the caribou in their zones. And that is unfortunate. So let's go to 8. I think that should be good, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I can't find any caribou in any of their zones that they're supposed to be in. It says they're supposed to be feeding now, and it's pretty clear that, like, we're within that time frame. At least we should be. So I don't know what's up there. I think they're just taking a very long time to get to their zones, which is unfortunate. So we may just have to sit here and wait. In the meantime, we have a couple of moose just kind of chilling here. So I think we're just gonna have to wait for our caribou to arrive. So far, though, just off of the first impressions of this location, I like this zone a little bit better. It looks a lot nicer, in my personal opinion. And it's got a lot more interesting species. Now, obviously, we haven't got to hunt a lot of them yet, but we have killed ourselves a moose and a bear. Overall, I think this is going to be a lot of fun. And the more we can progress, the more fun we'll have, I imagine. Very interested in how, like, this region is going to end with its pro hunts. That is going to be pretty crazy to see. But until then, we've got a lot of fun hunting ahead of us, going for the caribou, the moose, the bear, the whitetail, all those challenges for them. It's going to be fun. Absolutely nothing came to that stand the entire time of their feed zone, and we pretty much ran out of time, so we're going to have to go again. This is tougher than I thought it would be, just because they're not showing up. So what are we going to do? We could try starting at 9, because I think 9's in the middle of their feeding time, so they'd be there already, hopefully. And that would only give us an hour, though, to hunt them down. So that's going to suck a little bit. But hey, maybe it'll finally get us that kill we need. Let's go to... Probably... I mean, that one doesn't have very good angles. I want to go to this one, because that's the stand we were just in, and that was a really good stand. So let's head over there, and we'll see if we can make this happen. This has been a struggle. This is the most we have struggled on just like a normal challenge hunt in a while. This has been kind of brutal. Well, something's here. Probably those moose again. Yeah, moose. Where is the caribou? I don't get it. The caribou don't seem to be at any of their zones when they're supposed to be. What are we going to have to do to complete this? I mean, we went through the resting zone and they weren't there either. They're not in the feeding zone. Maybe try a different feeding zone? I don't know what to do at this point. We're just going to have to troubleshoot this, try a bunch of different things, see what works, see what doesn't. Because right now I've tried 3 different times to start at, and they're not in the zone they're supposed to be in. Who knows? Maybe it's bugged, but I doubt it. I mean, this game's pretty old. I would have thought they would have had, like, any major bugs fixed that would block progression, but I haven't seen a single caribou in any of their zones this entire time. Nothing in this zone either. Man, okay, so I think we're going to have to switch things up. Let's head down to the water, because that's the only type of zone I haven't gone near this entire time. I've gone through feeding zones and resting zones, but not drinking zones. So fingers crossed that this is where they are, and they're just like late to getting to their feed zone, or they've got like the times flipped around or something. Oh my gosh, right there. Yes, finally. Holy crap. So that's right there. Can I get up to a stand? I could get up to a stand, I think. Oh man, how am I gonna do this? I think they're coming over here. Yeah, they're coming over here. Okay. So this is going exactly to the spot that we were hunting before. Holy crap. They're right there. Oh my gosh, they're coming in really fast. We need to get in this tree stand like immediately. Otherwise, they're going to get downwind and spook off. Oh, they're right there. They're right there. Okay, we're in. We're in. Oh my gosh, there we go, finally. I think we got it. Yep, left lung. And right lung as well. Let's go. Beautiful. We did it. Oh my gosh, that took way longer than I expected it to. There he goes, he's down. So I guess it was just a problem with them being still in the process of walking to their zones, which I haven't ran into that too much unless I start, or if I start like at a certain time and then it transitions to the next zone. That's the only time I've had that issue. This is the first time I've had that issue where I actually start in their feed zone and they're not there. But we made it work, so that's all that matters. Hunt one caribou from a stand or blind is completed. Lovely. Love to see it, man. 3,700 credits. That's awesome. That's super awesome right there. So that brings us up to 13K. Man, we need to get a variable scope. The variable scopes I've heard are very, very good. So we need to work towards that. It's going to be pricey, though. 35,000 at the minimum. Ideally, we would like to get the 3-12 illuminated reticle. That's 65,000 credits, man. That's a lot of money. But if we get that scope, we'll never need to buy another scope, ever. Like, absolutely, we'll never need to buy another scope. So I'd love to get that. However, I would not be opposed to getting, like, the 6-12 either, because it's a lot cheaper. It's like 20K cheaper. We lose out on the illuminated reticle, but it still is the 6-12, which would be what we have now, plus like an extra 6X. So that would be nice. I would not be opposed to getting that one. We got a lot of grinding to do to get up there, though. Let's check what some of these are. 4,500 credits. Okay, we're doing that one. Hunt one black bear with a rifle. Minimum gear, 7mm. So we've got something above the 7mm. Let's start at 8. Yeah, we'll start at 8. Let's see how that one ends up going, because that's going to give us really good money. Let's see. Resting zone. So we just have to kill it with a rifle. It doesn't matter if it's from a stand or not. So that really opens up a lot of options in terms of approach. That's going to help us out quite a bit with making sure that we get it. Where is it at, though? Well, it's definitely not in its zone. Oh, I just saw something pop up, though. Oh, caribou and moose. 14x12. That is huge. They look stunning. Well, since there's no bears in the area, let's shoot a caribou. And then we'll figure things out with the bear after. If I can get a clean shot on these. Wait. Oh, hold on. I think the bear's right there. I just saw the little pop-up indicator for noise coming in this direction, or coming from this direction. So it's got to be here. Hopefully, at least. It was like right here I saw the indicator. I don't see a bear, though. Yeah, I don't see anything. Maybe I was completely wrong. That definitely looks like the nicest one, so let's go take him right now. I think that'll be clean. It was a kind of a weird angle, so I wasn't 100% sure, but yeah, that's good. Right in the lung. Double lung, in fact. And nothing spooked off from over here, so there was nothing over there, bear-wise. So that's going to be our first kill of this challenge, but it's obviously not the target animal, but I'll take an extra 1,200 along the way. Because we need a lot of money to get what we want. It's going to be a long time anyway. Oh! Holy crap. Okay, so maybe they're actually in their feeding zones. I mean, it's 8:30 right now. And it looks like from 9 to 1 would be the time that they're in their feed zone. So maybe we should go to the feed zones and just kind of set up on those and wait. That might actually work out pretty well. But in the meantime, let's grab this guy. That was definitely bigger than the other one we killed. Oh, yeah, that's beautiful. Gosh, the caribou look huge, man. The caribou look huge. I love them. 1,200 gear credits. Love to see it. And now let's head over to bear territory once again. Oh, so it looks like most of the bear territory is north of us. Okay. So let's head north. Or northeast, to be more specific. Oh, that's a bear. That's a bear for sure. That is exactly what the bears sound like in this game, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, I could be mistaken, but I don't think I am. I think we have bear right up ahead. Question is it the left or the right, like, indicator? I think it's the right side indicator, if my directional hearing is correct. But I mean, it could be both, even. Either way, we're really close to a bear. And shortly, we should have a bear on the ground, which would be challenge complete. Oh. Left one is not a bear. So the right one is a bear. I hear it in bushes too, which I don't like that because bushes are really close to me. There it is. I think that's good. I think. Maybe a little too far forward. Oh, we got it. Let's go. Okay, that's a lifesaver, man. That is a lifesaver that we actually hit that long. 338 is the best purchase we've made in this game. Like, nothing even comes close. This 338 could literally take us through this entire game. Aside from the hunts that require specific weapons, obviously. But holy crap. This gun is a monster. It is an absolute monster. Now I just need to find the blood. I probably should have paid attention. There it is. There's our blood. Let's keep following it. Shouldn't be too much farther down the line. He should die off super soon, I would imagine. Because he's been running for a little bit. Shut up, caribou. I don't care right now. We got a bear down. In fact, that's it right there. It ran a long ways, honestly. Like, it's clear down here. We shot it, like, way up here. That thing ran a long distance. Must have been single lung. I think it was single lung, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, single lung, so that's probably why. But we still completed it, so that's awesome. That's gonna be a lot of credits. 6,300. Oh my gosh. Yes. That's beautiful. That is what we want to see. We keep doing that. We'll be working our way up to that new scope in no time. Like super, super quick. What do we got here? 12 gauge required. 12 gauge. Recurve. Man. This whitetail hunt, we could do 7,500. Jeez. Hunt four whitetail deer with a rifle from less than 60 yards. And you get 7,500 plus all the credits from killing those. That's going to be over 12,000, I would imagine. Around like 12,000, maybe a little bit more. That's pretty sick. We have 7 hours to complete it as well. Let's start at 8 and head into this hunt. I think this will probably be our last hunt of the video, but it's going to be a banger. Oh my gosh. Holy crap. Some of those caribou were huge. But this is not a caribou hunt, so I'm not too worried about them. But oh my gosh, some of those were giants, man. Something's really close. I don't know how close, but something is like right on top of us almost, I think. Crap. Oh, it's all does anyway. Okay, so that was that was a bad idea. That was a bad idea indeed. What do we want to do? So they actually don't start feeding until 9. I may need to go. I think we're going to start at 9 instead. I think that's going to be the play here. Start at 9 instead. So let's redo that one. But we'll start at 9. There we go. That'll probably go a little bit better. So they'll just already be in the feed zones. Oh yeah, they're already there as well. So that makes things a lot easier. At least they're not going to pull a caribou on us and be miles away from the zone. Now, something I do want to kind of work towards is maybe getting some collars. I've read online that a lot of the animals in this game are very easy to hunt if you get collars. Like, you can just call them in, get them super close. Those are caribou. I thought the whitetail were here, but it looks like it's... Oh my gosh, they're here too. Don't move. Don't move. We should be good on the wind because the wind is blowing that way, but holy crap. That could have been really bad. You guys see nothing. No. You see nothing. You see nothing. That's all we need was 60 yards or less. We need four of those. Smoked him. That was the 60 yards or less we needed. I just barely got to 60 before they decided to spook, though. So that could have ended really badly. But I think we're good. I think we're honestly pretty good. I don't think it ran very far either, because it's just a whitetail deer. 338 kind of destroys them. Does it tell me the distance? No, it doesn't tell me the distance in here. But it counted. It did count, so we know for a fact that was what we needed. Now let's head to that feed zone over there. Oh, that wind, though. That wind is awful. I take that back. We're not going to go to that one. We're going to go here, and then up to that one, and then up to one of those. That's going to be a much smarter decision on my part because that wind is just not ideal to go to this zone that was over in like the west direction. So yeah, we're going to work our way up to this one and then work our way up to the ones above it too. There we go. There's some more deer. A nice 7x7 as well. 7x7, 6x5. We're going to go for the 7x7 if possible. But at the end of the day, we're just going to take whatever one gets within 60 meters first. But I would love to get that 7x7 if we can. He's facing away from us and the wind is good, so I think we should be okay to get close. Ooh. Oh, there's another 7x7. He's in an even better location. Guess that's the one we're going for. I guess that's going to be our guy. 75 yards away. We're getting there. Okay, back to prone. Back to prone. We'll just kind of chill for a second. We are in no rush. Ma'am, you can look away too. Come on. Thank you. Okay. That's good. We're super, super close. Oh, he's 58. He's 58. This is what we need. I just need broadside. I mean, we could probably hit that, but we want to make sure we get it. He's a 7x7 as well, but he's 77 away. Yeah, we just need this guy to go broadside. He's our dude. That should be fine. That should be fine. Oh, yeah. Easy lung. Easy lung. So that'll be deer number two down. Two more to go, and we will have a ridiculous amount of money. There we go. Let's follow the blood. Should not have gone too far. There he is. What a beauty. That's a good-looking deer. 280 on the score. We hit the stomach, so that sucks. Lost a little bit of credits for that. But we just need two more kills from within 60 yards, and we will be done with this challenge. Okay. Here we go. Number three. I think that's good, but it's going to be questionable. Because I couldn't see very good. Ah, dang it. No. That's still going to kill it, though. So I think it'll actually count. My hope is that it wasn't like measuring the distance to the reeds instead of the actual buck. Because that's going to throw a wrench into things. Okay. We might actually get a chance to shoot them again. Like the same group. I'm going to risk it. I don't know if I can shoot females or not. I think we can. I think we can. Okay. It just died. I think we're actually allowed to shoot females. See, that's something I've been questioning ever since we started this playthrough. And I think we're able to. If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I got 300 for that. It didn't count, though, for some reason. Was that not within 60 yards? What? There's no way that that wasn't within 60, right? I didn't look, but man, that sucks if that wasn't. Where did the buck die? Oh, no. Where did our buck die? It's got to be close, right? Well, I'm going to track that down, and we'll kind of go from there. There he is. Okay, let's pick this guy up. Please be within 60 yards. No, it wasn't. Oh, my gosh. That's so annoying that it measured the distance to the grass in front of it instead of the actual deer. That's terrible, man. That's awful. Well, nothing we can do aside from just getting back to the hunt and hoping we can get the last two that we need within the next couple hours of hunting. Because we only get 7 hours for the hunt. End time would be 1600. I don't know what time it is now. It's 1125. So we got a little bit of time, but not much. My gosh. The menus are a little bit annoying at times. As you guys have probably noticed, because hitting escape doesn't take you out of a menu. You have to press the same button that you press to get in to get back out. So it's a little bit annoying. But it is what it is at the end of the day. Okay, so we're getting the indicators. I assume this means white-tailed deer, although it definitely could be another species that happens to be drinking at the same time. But we'll see. I think it's most likely whitetail, since that is what is supposed to be here right now. It's going to be interesting, though, trying to get up here and getting a shot on them and just hoping that it's whitetail in the first place. Let's see. We should get a look now. Yeah, whitetail deer. Love to see it. The wind is good, too. Let's see if we can prone up there and get a shot. 6x5. I want the 7x7. Somebody in the comments told me they do get up to 8x8. I've never seen one of those, though, so I assume they're very, very rare. So that kind of gives us one more thing to look for. But right now, we're just looking for those 60-yard shots, which that 7x7, that's a 3x1. I think the 7x7 is right there. He's 70 away. That's not great. These does are like... Okay, you know what? Does it say bucks in this? Hunt four white-tailed deer with a rifle from less than 60 yards. It just says deer. So I could probably shoot one of the does. But just in case, I think I'll only shoot bucks. But this guy is actually giving us a perfect shot. Should be good. Let's just skip it to this part. Oh, yeah. Got him. Easy shot. Might have been our easiest shot of the day. We've had some tough encounters just due to, like, the foliage around the area and, like, wind direction and stuff. But that actually went very, very smoothly. So that was a quick little kill. I think he went up here. Yeah, he's right there. There we go. We hit stomach, but it's whatever. I just want to get these kills to finish this mission because, man, this has took a little bit longer than I thought it would. A little bit longer than I intended it to. And I would just like to get it done with. No! My game crashed! No! No, the game crashed. Why? All that progress is gone. Oh, how far is that going to set us back? Just that challenge, I hope. Well, let's get back in there and see. Moment of truth. How's it looking? Okay, looks like we still have all the other progress. It's just this. That hunt right there, no progress for that. That really sucks. Yeah, it sucks a lot. Wait, did we get the credits for it, though? I don't know what I was at before, but we're at 19,000 now. Let's see. We could buy the illuminated reticle 6X, but yeah, I'm not going to waste my money on that right now. So I think that's going to be it for this episode, guys. That was very unfortunate that we ran into some difficulties right there. Let's go to the trophy collection while we talk. Thank you guys so much for watching this series. I've been very happy to see that you guys have enjoyed this series pretty much just as much as you have any of our other series that we've done on the channel. Like, you guys have been watching these videos just as much as my Call of the Wild videos, so I really do appreciate that. I think you guys have been enjoying it, but you know, let me know in the comments if you have been or if you haven't. I will see you all in the next one. Hit the like button if you haven't already. Leave a comment. Subscribe if you're new and you enjoy the content. I'll see you later. Peace!